What do Leonardo DiCaprio and this robot have in common? The World Economic Forum is holding its annual meeting in Davos, Switzerland, and some of the world's top economists, politicians, and business people are there. US Vice President Joe Biden's promoting the fight against cancer, and Leonardo DiCaprio got an award for work on climate change. And then there's DRC Hubo. Developed by the Korea Advanced Institute of Science and Technology, it's at Davos to show off its skills. Hubo earned an invite after beating 28 teams to win the 2015 DARPA Challenge. It can walk, kneel, and drive on two wheels, but slowly. Despite the speed, it's still pretty advanced for a humanoid robot. When researchers develop them, they often focus on their role in disaster response, because robots can be sent into places too unsafe for humans. But robots also pose a larger question for the global economy. What happens when they get sophisticated enough to begin replacing humans in all types of jobs? At the conference, Swiss bank UBS launched a report that said the rich will benefit most from robots just for that reason. Less humans mean higher profit margins. The economic brains at Davos might ponder that as they watch the demo, or maybe not. Also Monday, a call to study science from musician Will.i.am, who was receiving an award for his work on education.
And I want kids to dream to be like Steve Jobs, not just Stevie Wonder. I want kids to dream to be like Bill Gates. I want them to discipline and dedicate their lives to solving the world's problems.
Davos continues all this week. Major tech attendees include Bill Gates, Satya Nadella, Alibaba's Jack Ma, Eric Schmidt, Sheryl Sandberg, and GM's Mary Barra.